Hello guys, welcome back to a new video. Today we're going to be doing round 4 of the 2023 season mod, career mode series I'm doing, not for 2023, because I thought, we'd do it. Round 3 went really well. We did get points in the end for that, so that was a great effort by us. Here we go for, we're in 8th in the we're 8th in the driver championship. That's pretty good. Got Fernando Alonso and Lance Stroll. Next person we need, we're in 7th in the driver's, 7th in the constructors. But anyway, shit, I forgot to do our famous thing. I forgot to take out the, this. Fucking hell, I hate this so much. I hate this. Never mind. It's life in it, and this happens sometimes. So, alright, let's go. So, I'm just gonna have to load this in because I forgot to load in. There we go. Okay, so now we could go to. I'm sorry, I'm pretty bad YouTuber. Well, I'm not that bad, but just I need to be accurate now. Still new upgrades to the car. I need to get some more upgrades. It's a sprint weekend anyway, so yes, sprint weekend, as you can see here, sprint. So 5 laps and 16 laps for the race. So we might just do one practice session. We're gonna probably do the practice session program, and we're gonna do the qualifying program. And here we go. It's probably that's good. So we got some. Good old data. Good old. Finish that out easy. Just trying to do this one. We can do it. Oh, what a shame. So we didn't get it in time, so we're gonna have to. Actually, F122 is a really bad game anyway, but. Just like the qualifying speed. Like, the game isn't that bad. Come on. Let's just say it. Like, isn't that bad. Well, yeah, but with. I think the only thing is keeping it alive is probably the. Career mode, and also, well, not career mode, I'm trying to say the season mods keeping it alive, because people are playing season mods now on the game, and the season mods are pretty good. You could just play 2020. 2020 was a good game as well, but, we go for qualifying, and, it's on a Friday. We did do the qualifying program, and that went pretty well, so here we go for the program. I don't know why there's no data. It's a bit of a weird bug issue. That I don't know why there's no data. Oh, there we go. This is so broken, man. Like, this is broken. There we go. It works now. It's just like a weird bug thing that keeps happening. We're gonna have to get out of there and qualifying. Do a lap time. Potentially do a lap time. So we'll do 5, 15. I think I'll be alright. From speed to
okay, key, we'll alter the setup of the car.
There we go, just gonna get us straight out there straight away in the car. Should we go for also pinging my controller today? If you're wondering what the fuck, like, why is driving all a bit weird, it's because as you can see. Which also does take the best lap time, so might have to do a good lap time to get into a good lap time to maybe even get a good lap time for not Q2, obviously, it's only just it's only a short qualifying, so might get up to P5 if you can do that. That'd be a good lap time if you can. So let's see what we can do basically in this half. So
okay.
Alpine will be changed for probably next video as well, so Alpine will be changed from the pink to the blue again.
V6 isn't that bad.
Just doing another
I think that'd be it. Personally, I'm gonna
go in the pit lane anyway.
So yeah, so that's P7. Did beat our teammate just about with the lap times, so that was a decent lap time actually. Well, yes, now with Max Verstappen in P1 with like maybe in the second slow. Yeah, in 15th now, as you can see, with Pierre Gasly hasn't done a lap time. Fernando Alonso is in P5 in the Aston Martin, P6 Lewis Hamilton, don't know what's going on there. Lando Norris isn't really gonna. We're gonna try to do another lap time anyway, so. Kevin's out there straight away, so we're just gonna. We're 16th anyway, so we're just gonna get out there straight away. So we've got one more set of tyres anyway, we're 17th, teammates in 14th. So yeah, we do seem to get good qualifying speed. Like this race speed is really cool. Like really cool? I mean really fast. The race speed is good. We're really quick. But getting qualifying speed, I don't think our cars are great, but in the race, it's pretty spot on. We did get points last race, and that's good. If we can get another points for this, that'd be fantastic. For the team, yellow flags. And green again. Nice and steady, don't need to mess up our lap time. Trying to go really quick around these corners as we actually do. Break nicely and get into the next corner. Much better lap time now. I might just draw them up. My lap time deletion anyway, so that's it pretty much. Our lap time this is over basically. Max Verstappen does take the fastest lap with Fernando Alonso in P2, so that'd be it for good qualifying for us, which is a shame, but you know, it's okay, not the end of the world, in the NASCAR. 17th overall, but yeah, it's a little bit shocking for Haas, but you know.
Now with qualifying complete, let's review our top three today, Verstappen, Vettel and Charles Leclerc. Goodbye for now then, we are really just getting started. Make sure you join us again for Lights Out tomorrow.
Get a little bit of a better lap time, but yeah. I forgot. No, it's copyright music. Shit, this copyright music. Shit. Oh man, this copyright music. Copyright music, get it off quickly. 20 centimeters between 7 in the construction job, but anyway, so points. Well, 40 points, but the month. So I'm just going to get change. I do really want to know that.
Forget pit stops, forget fuel management. It's pedal to the metal all the way here as we get ready for today's sprint. Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks for today's sprint. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday and he'll start from pole position, with Sebastian Vettel starting alongside. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Leclerc, Russell, Fernando Alonso, and Hamilton. Sainz, Norris, Ocon, and Guan Yu Zhou. Perez, Gasly, Alex Albon, and Bottas. Ricciardo, Stroll, Hughes, and Kevin Magnussen, Tsunoda, and Nicholas Latifi. And with preparations almost complete, let's head trackside for today's sprint.
Okay, this is our engine supplier's home Grand Prix, so let's give them the race worth watching.
Oh, fucking hell. This always does this, doesn't it? I have to go out, come back in, do it again, because it keeps fucking playing up as usual. As usual. Sprint. Oh, oh, oh. Verstappen just looked at the car, giving Fernando Alonso the lead, giving Charles Leclerc P2 and George Russell P3, George Russell P4, invited to Lewis Hamilton. Why did he do that? Dumbest idea I've ever seen in my life. Max Verstappen just locked up and not listening to the business. Stupid idea, Max. Come on. Just a two-time world champion. He's in dead last now. Up to P12. And Sergio Perez is in P9. What the hell is going on? Red Bull just keep that on meltdown mode. Trying to catch up to Alex Albon. So Toronto doesn't know if it's a good pick up. Charles in the lead.
Okay, gap ahead is 3.0 seconds.
Blue flag.
Green flag.
Are you serious? Nick the Freeze had an incident as well.
isn't it, Quai? So far, and Charles Leclerc wins the sprint. Yeah, still pretty tall, though, so.
Right, race over. Take care of the car on the way
in. Let's have a quick look at how the drivers' standings have changed. The gap at the top of the championship has been cut down after a difficult race for our championship leader. Let's move on to the constructors. The lead at the top comes down after a strong weekend from the challenging pack. With the sprint wrapped up, we now have our grid line up for the big race tomorrow. Be sure to join us then for what will no doubt be a fantastic race.
Stop. It's 19th at the moment. Sergio Perez did get one single. Charles Leclerc in first place. What the hell is going on? I don't know.
Welcome once again to the Autodromo Internazionale Enzo Andino Ferrari. The clue is in the name. This is very much Ferrari home turf, and the locals will be out in force today to support their team in what we hope will be a magnificent spectacle of motorsport. On then to the Emilia-Romagna Grand Prix. A lap of Imola, anti-clockwise of course, unlike most Formula One circuits, will take our drivers round 3.1 miles of track. 19 turns, 9 right-handers and 10 left. Drivers will need to be precise at the hairpin turn 7, given the subsequent uphill section. Without a good exit from that corner, they'll lose a lot of time on that stretch. It's time to take a look at our starting grid for today's race. Fantastic effort from Charles Leclerc yesterday, and it's put him on pole. And starting alongside in P2 is Sebastian Vettel. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Russell, Fernando Alonso, Sir Lewis Hamilton, and Sainz, Ocon, Perez, Norris and Guan Yu Zhou, Albon, Hughes, Lance Stroll and Ricciardo, Bottas, Magnussen, Yuki Tsunoda and Nicholas Latifi. Verstappen and Pierre Gasly picks up the final grid slot today. That's it then, it's time to go racing as we head down trackside for today's race. It's race day yet again, and joining me for a chat, Anthony Davidson. Ant, our racers are certainly in for a rough day today. What will you be watching for as they go down into turn one?
Well, the start of the race is always one of the most nerve-wracking parts. You have to hope that everyone is able to get off to a clean start, and this is possibly the trickiest part of the entire race. So many drivers in such a small space, and finding your braking point into turn one as well. It's a testament to the driver's skill that there aren't more incidents.
After the points finished last race, let's aim to keep that momentum going.
shit start. Jeffrey does take it, and once again there's an issue with my HUD. Pushing the margin, aren't they? It's not going to go for the lead. We're going to go for a little bit of a look. But no. Charlotte Claire's in all
the heat. Okay, you're in the top 10.
Ocon's out. What the hell happened? No, we're just gonna go for the move. And then there was a yellow flag going on, such and such. So basically, Charles Leclerc did a really. Basically, there was a lockup going on here. Hit us. And, oh, bit of a fucking issue. Okay, Ocon actually had a lockup. Hit us. Actually, his own car, so he had a. Oh, I've switched my car. Ocon. Out. It was quite screwed, really, that literally, who was it? Max Verstappen there, all the other drivers were there, but it's kind of extraordinary that Charles Leclerc is in P1. Charles Leclerc doing a great job in first place. And extraordinary that supercars now deployed.
Available on the MFD. Okay, copy that.
Alright, that's a bit of a weird glitch going on there again. Logan's. Oh, it's Alex Albon. Logan's out. Logan's out. We could pit now, actually. I am thinking about pitting now, but 28 comfortable position, tyres are likely in the front of that too anyway, so. I'm saying pit now, so why not? No brainer to pit now.
Right, drop your speed, our delta's too low, we're going to risk a penalty. Slow your pace immediately.
No brainer, pitting now. And Alonso's pitting. I'm pitting now. Pit. Or mayhem in the pit lane then.
That was a fantastic pit stop, actually. Good pit stop.
Good old pit stop.
That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Let's go.
Yeah, Gasly is being
could actually get Pierre Gasly and Charles. You never know. Verstappen is right behind us.
Safety car in this lap. Let's make sure those tyres are up to temperature. Remember, there's no overtaking until the timing line. Stay in position until the green flag.
What the hell was that, teammate? Like, literally. Looked up. Hey, that was so not right. Then, so he's got a mechanical problem. He's actually seriously having a problem. So it's going to be easy to overtake Charles Leclerc. It's going to be good for the move.
Good old teammate. the race and believe such. He'd be happy if we win this race, so which at this stage isn't a lot, although the drivers are basically with the P1 now, because everybody else has to pit. Lewis has to pit, Fernando has to pit, Little Sargent, pretty much most of the midfield. Has to definitely pit. Joe Brand New has to pit. Definitely Joe Brand New. Definitely.
DRS has been enabled. DRS is now enabled.
Oh, there goes the pits. Next to go. Max Verstappen in P11 now.
The car behind is dropping back by about 3/10 of that. Well done.
Second position. Oh, and he gets up to P4.
Gap to the car in front is 6.3 seconds. some gearbox wear, so try to keep the number of shifts to a minimum, please. Okay, Kevin's in for his stop now.
got P4 for the end of the race, that's really good. Really good. Nick de Vries did get driver of the day. 20th to 5th.
What has been another outstanding Grand Prix.
Charlotte for one.
Anthony, tell me, what was it that helped them achieve this success?
Well, this was a real team victory. They put together a solid strategy today that appeared well suited to the conditions out on track. The driver did everything that was expected of them in the moment to really execute the team's plan to perfection. A shining example of how F1 really is a team sport.
Well done.
Ferrari are at it again. An excellent performance at today's Grand Prix. And they're certainly a team that know what they're doing out there. It was not the best weekend for our championship leader, and their advantage at the top has been reduced. So let's review the drivers' standings. Some amazing talent out there on track today, but Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
I'll probably go for Pierre Gasly. The team did a good job with the strategy to put him in amongst the pack, but it's the driver's job to capitalise on those opportunities, and he did so with a lot of skill.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. Ferrari take the lead at the top of the table. It was also a strong Grand Prix from Haas F1 this weekend. Fantastic work from the American team to move themselves further up the table. After an event like that, who knows what the sport has in store for us next time? Be sure to join us again as we continue to bring you the latest excitement in Formula One.
Guys, so thank you so much for watching, guys. I really enjoyed that, guys, but just got some new upgrades.
Yep.
Our new parts are completed without issue. They'll be on the car ready for the next race weekend.
So anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching, and yeah, thank you so much for watching, guys. That's it for me today, and for next race, we'll be going into Miami for the fifth race of the season for the F1 23 season mod career mode series I'm doing. So, yep. It's a great race, actually. And we are at P7 in the Drivers' Championship, so that's good. Haas are fourth now, so that's good. Anyway, thank you so much for watching, guys. Bye-bye.